lift up my soul unto thee, O Lord. Do I lift up my soul? Oh my God, I trust in thee.
I find out that all his prophecy in my life always come to pass. It is not as if
the Lord,
he always predicts. You understand? I have met so many men of God. I'm not that type of person that I will see anybody giving prophecy and I will be surprised. I've seen a lot of them. Many of them are fake. Many of them will be predicting. But Prophet Nonso, his own is authentic and original.
I appreciate
he
you
will
that.
Tell you how it is and how it's going to be. So then, I was actually busy with my freight forwarding business there. He told me that I saw you traveling. I was confused. I was surprised because it's not in my agenda. I don't have any interest traveling abroad. You understand? Well, when he said that, I said, okay, well, good and fine. But when it later came to pass, I didn't plan for it. I didn't commit my money in it. It was a favor. I find myself there to the glory of God. Then I remember that this was the prophecy that Prophet Nosso gave to me.
I appreciate the Lord for that.
Glory be to God.
Amen.
Secondly, while I was there working anyway, I don't know, I can't even explain what happened, but all I know is that I find myself here. When I realized I've found myself in Nigeria was when I get to Murtala Mohammed. I was getting
sorry,
buy,
my brother.
Buy gala, buy gala, buy bottled water.
My
because
brother.
The difference is clear.
Hello, was, my brother. Please, which country did you travel to?
Dubai.
Dubai.
So I was
appreciate
surprised.
God for that. I appreciate God for that. The prophet gave him a message. The man of God gave him a message that he saw him traveling and he was not even thinking of traveling. Amen. But it came to pass. I appreciate God for that.
So, brothers and sisters, what I was saying is, when I came back to this country, I didn't plan for it. It was as if it was cancellation of visa, unexpected. They notified me that your visa has been cancelled. I say, it's just like that. Before I know it, I found myself here. Then I started making arrangements on how to travel to another country. And where I have in mind to go was North America and Canada, precisely. So when I meet the man of God, though I've already committed something on that Canada visa before I met the man of God, it was a mistake anyway. When I met him, he told me to go and write country that I want to go to. Then I went at the back there, I wrote the country. When I came to the altar, the man of God told me what I wrote, that I wrote North America, a boundary between Europe and North America. Then I showed him that it was exactly what he said that I wrote on the paper. He said, Nidan, let me pray for you. So after the prayer, we started the procedure of the visa. After that, he told me that this is what I'm seeing in this, your Canada visa, that you have not seen any light there. You understand? That is he's seeing me in a different country. Then I was like, because one of my uncle was giving me a different prophecy that, in fact, it will go through, it will be a success story, and I have committed money already. I don't know how to go back and leave the money I've committed already. I said, since I have started this one, let me just finish it. I was asking man of God to continue to pray for me, that when God is involved, the difference will be clear. I continue praying for where there is no road for me. Then he later told me, I think it was after 2 weeks, he told me that he saw me in Asia continent. That if I should go to Canada, that I would be there 15 years, struggling. That he saw me in Asia continent. That's where I was doing very, very well, to the glory of God. Then I was still hoping on the Canada stuff. I waited for 11 months. It was this January that I went to the office. In fact, they give me their final conclusion that they cannot do anything about it again, that they denied the visa. Then I was then frustrated. I don't know what to do, where to start, because I spent so much money. I spent so much money on it. If I'm to go to another country, I don't even have money to start all over again. But it was a favor. A friend of mine called me that he had an Arab connection. And as I'm talking to you now, my Arab connection visa is out.
Praise the Lord. Job,
so after all my effort and struggle to go to America, I'm still going to Asia continent, according to what Prophet Nosso prophesied.
I appreciate the Lord for that.
So glory be to God. I respect his grace a lot.
Amen. I appreciate God for that. I appreciate God for that. You see?
Yes, sir.
Amen.
Amen.
Grace are of different sizes.
Yes, sir.
And grace are of different heights.
Uh-huh.
You know, when the man of God prophesied to him and told him initially that he saw him traveling, he never had it in mind. But it came to pass. And when he traveled and found himself back, he now had interest to travel. But where he was looking at, there was no light there, according to the man of God, but he has already committed his resources. Yes. You know, when you have spent much, you can't go back again. You now begin to ask God for God permissive will. Amen. You know, God, I know there's no life, but at the end, it did not work out. But thank God that God now favored him and rechanneled him to where he's to go. Appreciate God for that. Appreciate God for that. We serve a living God. Yeah. Amen.